So that's the Chaturanga one. So as you see with that, we have to hug those elbows in towards the rib cage. That's very important. And we want the shoulder to elbow alignment. Now the second one, we'll start in a fold here. So bend at the knees, we can step or hop back, flowing through Chaturanga. So the second version, we can lower down halfway, hugging the elbows in, nice and straight in the tailbone. Come to the front of the feet, press up, pull the heart through, look up, and then exhale for down dog. That's option number two. So what I see a lot in my classes, some people, as we are going through that up dog, they stay on the balls of the feet and press themselves up. We don't want that. That's too much in the lower back. We want to come to the front of the feet so that we're opening up in the ankles. Then come back, down dog. It's very important that we hug these elbows in as well, so that we're creating strength for the upper body, and it prepares us for those arm balances, those crazy, you know, yoga poses that we see all of those people doing. So that's how we build up that upper body strength so we can get there, but we gotta make sure that we're doing it the correct way. So by doing the Chaturanga the correct way, you're building up that strength, even though it may not be straight through the plank, that's fine. We have to build up that muscle so that we can get there. So just keep at it. If it doesn't look perfect, keep doing it over and over so that you can build up that muscle to get there. This is yet another Tuesday with Dreanna Menachiyogi. Hope that you like the video. Please comment, subscribe, share. Give me any feedback. I'm always open to hearing new things that I can improve on. Thank you for your time.